Hey bro, thought you could use a break. I've come here to relieve you of duty for a while.
Take care.
FAB. Now, where's the comms room?
To your left, Alan.
Welcome home, John.
John, don't make yourself too comfy just yet. We have a situation.
What is it, Thunderbird 5?
The air-terrain vehicle Fireflash had crashed, supposedly. Well, one of the five did. Heathrow Tower confused about the problem. It's believed the engine just died. Like it just... meow, boom, right in the ocean.
Alright, Alan, I guess.
They're doing two more flights in the upcoming couple of days. Would you like me to keep you informed?
Well, that is your job up there.
Alright then.
Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Thunderbirds are go.
In this process of this flight, we'll be staying informed with the pilot Ned Tenford, who has also worked previously on Fireflash. Any questions? Alright then, Captain Hansen, this is London Tower. You are clear for takeoff. Begin your ascent.
Ah, Norman, flying this was like a breeze. Until a bomb was planted on the wing and Interstellar Rescue had to come and save it.
Let's hope nothing like that goes down this time. I'm not one for the whole terrorist stuff.
That puts me in the lead.
Hey, I call it cheats.
Come on, bro. Don't be such a sore loser.
So, what are you up to?
Pool?
Hey, how come we never used to play pool when I was there?
So, Alan... any news on the Fireflash?
No, other than the fact that it launched fine 12 minutes ago. It's on the right course and is running fine.
Thanks, Alan. You're doing a good job.
Guys, we have something weird happening up here.
What is it, Thunderbird 5?
The Fireflash has changed its course without the pilots even knowing.
Is that even possible?
Apparently so. I recommend that TB2 launches just in case.
I'll come too. I've been doing diagnostic scans of Fireflash ever since the first accident.
Alright then, Thunderbirds are...
go! Sorry.
Thank you.
Norman, have you changed course?
No. Why?
Fireflash seems to be heading west instead of flying east.
Ned!
What?
Look!
Number 2, I've lost Fireflash from the radar. I'm going to send you its last coordinates that I've seen. It seems to be way out into the ocean, so I would definitely prepare for number 4.
I'm on it.
We're doomed! We jinxed it! Norman, I blame you.
Number 4, we're at the drop zone.
System check complete. Docking camps are released, and we are go for modular deployment.
I'm going to do a 1,000 mile radius scan from the last coordinates to see if I can pick up a reading on the Fireflash.
Any readings yet, bro?
Just keep swimming forwards. I think it's there.
Swimming?
You know, like finding... Never mind. Just carry on.
Found it.
Scans coming in. Human life! It's been detected! Cockpit! Top of the airliner!
FAB Allen.
A quick look at Fireflash's weight indicates that it's too heavy. And a key source of this is its engine. But number 4, you know what to do.
God, we're going to die! Dying! Did you know 100% deaths happen because of dying?
Tedford, calm down. Look!
Gordon, that's all for now. Return to the pod. Virgil's going to lower me down to the Fireflash with a laser cutter.
FAB, John.
Don't worry. We're going to get you out.
Deep breath. Deep breath. Deep breath!
Come on out. Safe now.
War pilot Calibor.
I apologize for him. Thank you, International Rescue.
I see you're aware of this whole Fireflash situation.
Yes, we are, and we have a proposal for you.
Go ahead.
Our engineer. Mr. Hackenbacher, it is. He's going to design and engineer the next air-terranium vehicle to take off if that's okay with you.
Great idea. I see the Thunderbird stay in shape every day, so we could with some extra touches on the airlines.
Great. One of our pilots will have Mr. Hackenbacher over shortly for a short press conference on the air-terranium situation.
Well, Brains, you're coming to London, me. Or should I say... Mr. Hackenbacher.